Hello, so I played around and I unlocked some other mission types. So for now we just have scouting, which is basically a harder version of the normal scouting. And you have this one, $55. Well, that's not too much, okay, but the final mission of this chapter is the hunting, and if you vanquish a poltergeist, you get this amount of money. So that's what? 1,000 times more profitable? No, and that's because it's very hard to reach this stage in the game. So sweeping is also where we encounter the ghouls, but for now, forensics is too easy. Let's do another scouting and then we'll buy another weapon and maybe we'll go and kill some ghouls. Oh, and this game is perfect to play at night, because when you play at night, sometimes you'll get scared and your mouse will suddenly jump out of your hand or something, I don't know. They did a really good job with the atmosphere and actually improved the atmosphere right now, so yeah, you'll see what I mean. I'll actually play this one a little faster, because I'm, believe it or not, a pro at this game, or was, until I lost my save and didn't play for almost 2 years. Eh. I really wish they would, you know, release some more content for the game this week. Or this month. Knock knock. Okay, that's a very bad start. I can't really fight this thing inside the house. Oh, that's... Yeah, I needed more range. Oh man, this is not working. Okay, that should have been a little easier, but they only surprised me, and if they surprise you, you basically lost. Yeah, it's hard to fight them outside sometimes, but I prefer it, because inside you'll basically get thrown all over the place and hit the furniture. Well, speaking about the furniture, you can avoid that, but it's very hard. Unless you see from where it flies at you, you'll just get hit. And by the way, that also closes all the doors in the house, so yeah, be careful. Well, so much for fast playing the game. Okay, so the hallway is actually the best place to do it. To fight the spiders. The shadows are so creepy. Oh, and did I mention later on you'll actually encounter new varieties of enemies and poltergeists? Such a bad place to fight. Anyway, the ghouls can also come from the bathroom. They usually hang on the ceiling. So they can be anywhere in the house. And the later variety of cryptids include some of the worst. Meaning a very big spider, bigger than the ones we are fighting right now. Ghouls, two ghouls actually, one or two depending on the difficulty of the mission. You know, that always scares me when I'm playing at night. Okay, we are far away enough to avoid it. And this thing actually moves in the darkness. It crawls. Before, they were so big, they're actually 2 times smaller, but I think they at one point they thought, hey, this is not big enough, and they doubled them in size. And also later on, depending on where they chase you, by the way, this can happen. For example, if I had went this other way with the anxiety paid on my on my trail, I could have okay. Nasty. I could have unlocked another group of enemies. See how they have a still didn't reload. Okay, the reload mechanics are a bit weird. They are a bit weird in the beginning because I have a penalty to reloading my SMG. Because Because I don't have the skill for the SMG, so that's why it's taking so long. So if you go down the wrong way, you can actually fight more groups of the cryptids. Yeah, imagine fighting the spiders and the big centipede at the same time. Also, the room has some white noise. White noise is like, I don't know, some thing that is in the background. Oh, he still got me. Okay. So as you can see, the room has kind of like a humming sound to it. And this all is what makes the game so scary. Okay, the house is clear now. Let's search for clues. Yeah, until we get better gear, sadly this is kind of how we have to do it. It's a very slow and methodical process. There's no point in analyzing the corpse in shorter missions like this one, because it will only reveal some information about the enemies, and I killed all the enemies, so it's not important to do that right now. Okay, so let's search every room carefully. Yeah, even though you clear all the cryptids, the paranormal events still happen. Oh. And now they're actually throwing some trails just to confuse you. Sorry if that's too loud, and that triggered a Steam achievement, so that was that sound, that weird sound. Okay, that's one. Yeah, even the Ghostbusters would be afraid to play this game. Look at all the scenery. The window is meshed, and this is technically a new house, but thanks to the cryptids and the supernatural invasion, it looks like it's much, much older. And by the way, some of the clues you find can be a bit more rare, and some of them are really, really strange and terrible. Okay, so at this point I know that I have to find another clue with the... What is this thing called? No, not the pocket light, it's... Yeah, it's the pocket light, what? Okay, let's just search for the other clue. We have to search it with the blue light or whatever this thing is. Okay, we got a trail. Let's follow it. Okay, now sometimes you get other objects, but usually you just have to unleash the first thing. And on the second one, usually you have to put something that can identify the monster, so the symbol. Let me see, one is bigger, one is smaller. Esoteric. Okay, so the enemy, the poltergeist on this mission would be a kelpie, but we're not going to fight it. Nope, never. Well, I kind of need about 20 hours. By the way, the game does that automatically. So even though you think you are safe, you still... By the way, let's listen to this thing. Tasmanian Megalopod. Yeah, it shows you the location of the monsters, but we already cleared it. And it will also drain your blue light. So yeah, there are a lot of things that will stop you from, you know, achieving your goal. Now, where did I put my car? That's always a problem in this game. Where did you leave your car? Sometimes the car can disappear because there is a poltergeist or a thing that actually messes with your car as well. So I'm not going to craft anything right now. So let's sell everything. The pig head is actually quite expensive. Pig mask, $51. White fur, $17. Okay, so that was a lot of money we just made. Let's go back to our safe house and I'll explain a few more things in detail. I'm getting those really expensive clues just because I have this skill, Treasure Hunter. What I don't have is the guns for the SMGs. Now, I'm level 6, so I guess I can take the SMGs as well. Okay, so now we know how to use the SMGs. I kind of want the gun attachments or the... I also have first aid. I want a lot of things in the game. But you're limited in this kind of like early access version, so let me see. So now we can actually reload the SMG in 2 seconds. Or what was it? Okay, in 2 seconds. Before we had a penalty of another 2 seconds, so 4 seconds, but now it's actually 2 seconds to reload it. Ah, it's much better. And now we just need to do a lot of missions. I paid this guy $200 and he'll have new stuff for us soon. Very, very soon. He will actually bring the next row of weapons, but until he does that, we have to complete, I think, the missions with the ghouls. So let's get the micro SM. It's the Uzi. I'm okay with it. We'll also keep that one because I like it. Now, I think we have a little... No, we don't have enough money for the leather jacket. Would have been cool if I had enough money for the medical jacket or the first aid, but no. So let's see if we can hunt down some ghouls. As you can see, that gets put over there. It still uses the same ammunition type, but I'll have to buy more of it. What? It doesn't use the same ammunition type? But it uses. And later on, when you keep the gadgets and the weapon attachment and also the auxiliary stuff, it will be a different game. It's the more you play, the more complex it gets. So let's buy some extra ammunition, 1000, so we never run out of it. And let's do a harder mission, the sweeping, because we also have a quest for it. As you can see, we have a disturbance here, so it will be harder to gather the signs or the quests, but you get a bonus for killing all the cryptids. So you get a bonus for deduction here. And here you get a bonus for killing all the cryptids and you'll find more signs. Anyway, let's just get to the mission. So the game has a weird habit of getting harder and harder, but more interesting, but also more annoying. And sometimes when you open a door, you can go into the shadow dimension. Or you fight the invisible bulls. Well, they won't be exactly invisible with the right attachment, but still quite hard. And yeah, I'm a little bit, I don't know, I'm angry about the game because this is one of the better horror games that I've played, one of the better isometric games, one of the better RPGs, but still the developers are planning a lot of stuff for the last 2 years, but nothing really has been done. So I'm a bit upset. Early access should be maximum 1 year, not 2 years, not 3 years, not 4, not 5. By the way, this weapon is about, I don't know, 40% better than the first one. And we can actually reload this weapon. Okay, no ghouls around here. And that's it, that's how fast the weapon can reload. Yeah, before you could dodge, roll and reload your weapon, but not anymore. Okay, now get two smaller ones, okay. I guess the smaller ones are not so bad. But they're still annoying. Let me see the glossary, no. Actually it is here, cryptids. So this is the blood crawler. I have to buy the entry to read about it, and then you can do some other things, find its weak point and stuff like that. The game gets a lot more complex, like I said, but... Oh, the smaller spiders are so annoying. They sound like they go on your brain. Spiderling, and we also have some other stuff to unlock, but there are not a lot of enemies in the first chapter. But the game will get more dangerous as you'll also get more poltergeist or geists or just ghosts in general. So in this mission we should have one. Okay, we should have one ghoul in this mission, one or two ghouls. And they are huge and they have claws, very long claws. And you don't want to mess with them, especially right now because I don't have a lot of armor. Okay, that things will actually... This thing will actually throw spikes at you, and sometimes it can come out of corpses. What was that? So the corpse parasite, the ghoul, the blood chloros. Yeah, we're actually seeing a lot of new enemies around here. Come on, mouse. Don't fail me now. I just like to make a lot of noise in case some of the enemies are high. So I think I was hitting this thing over here. Yeah, so depending on what you hit with your bullet, you'll actually make a different sound. Let's check that again. And I think if you eject your shells on the carpet... Ah, no, they make the same sound. I guess they still need to work on some of the aspects of the game. So did we clear all the... We didn't kill all the cryptids. I died. Yeah, that was a bad place to fight it because, you know, I should have dodged better, but it's hard to fight them when you have a very small space at your disposal. Eh, well, we lost a little bit, but we gained a little bit of money anyway. Cool. I guess I need a little more armor because this is definitely what I'm missing. Let's actually see if we can buy the better armor, the leather jacket. Yeah. The security vest will be a heavy armor. The rugged coat is also heavy armor, so... Yes. You just upgrade your gear as you go by. Leather jacket, mountain boots, micro SP 3. Okay, that was kind of annoying that I lost in the last second, because I think that was the last cryptid on the map. I'm also out of practice, and I could have used a trap for him. But I don't think they will respond too well to the fire traps anyway. Anyway, see you next time when I have more tools available. This is for a quest, also we don't have the schematics for this stuff. Oh, see you next time, bye!